Do you like Super Metroid? Do you like horror? Do you like biomorphic lethal parasites? Then do I have the game for you. Metroid Fusion released in 2002 and was the fourth installment in the Metroid series by Nintendo. Have you ever heard of the phrase, if it ain't broke, don't fix it? Well, the Metroid Fusion developers certainly had. Because Metroid Fusion can definitely be called Super Metroid 2.0. Now, I'm not saying this is a bad thing at all. Super Metroid is a legend when talking about Super Nintendo games, as well as being an overall fan favorite in the Metroid game series. In fact, this game plays and feels so familiar because it was developed by the same team who worked on Metroid 3, which is a rare thing nowadays in the modern gaming industry. While Fusion mirrors Super Metroid controls to a T, the game offers a much more involved and progressive narrative storyline as you play. Traditionally, the Metroid games up to this point have very little narrative as the game progressed, almost like the Doom series, but for what it lacked in the story department, it made up for in its gameplay and atmosphere. In Metroid Fusion, you get a perfect mix of all these things. It marries the boring elevator scenes with many cliffhanger storylines as you progress, giving you small glimpses into Samus' past as well as her thoughts on her journey thus far. All the sci-fi action-based gameplay is back, but this time also throws in great horror elements that definitely make Fusion stand apart from the past Metroid games. The soundtrack for Fusion is outstanding, being an original title for the Game Boy Advance having 48 new songs for this game. The attention to detail in the environments never ceases to amaze me. even looking at Samus as she stands still, is very impressive. The plot of the game breathes in new life into the semi-tired storyline of fighting space pirates and Mother Brain. Taking place soon after the events in Metroid 3, Samus is surveying the planet SR388 when she is attacked by an unknown floating organism. Not knowing her body has been compromised by the organism, she ends up losing consciousness while her ship floats off into an asteroid belt. Having been saved by a rescue team, they discover Samus has not only been infected by this unknown virus, but is close to death. Quickly, they find a cure for the parasite using DNA from the Metroid. Upon being cured, much of Samus's suit needed to be surgically removed, and most of her various suit powers had been lost. But in return, Samus is now immune from the ex-parasite and can absorb their energy to replace her own. It reminds me very much of how, in Alien Resurrection, Ripley is cloned and now has the alien DNA mixed in her genetic code, giving her similar traits to the xenomorphs, such as acid blood, ultra senses, and abnormal strength.
Ripley? Ripley. You've had enough fun.
The hell are you?
Something of a predator, isn't she?
Yeah, she continues to make us all very proud.
Tension is added to Samus's combat effectiveness due to having the Metroid DNA in her body. Because, just like the Metroid, she is now vulnerable to the same elements as the Metroid, such as cold and being able to be frozen easily. As Samus is about to depart, a distress signal is sent from the space station where she was rescued. Something has gone terribly wrong with the ex-parasites, and the space station is under attack from an unknown assassin. Being underpowered and left in the dark, Samus heads back to the station, not knowing what horror and devastation she's about to face. Once I began to play Metroid Fusion, I could not help but admire how this story felt like a good survival horror game I could sink my teeth into, much like the Dead Space series. For retro gamers and Metroid fans, this is a must-own. While Super Metroid will always be my favorite game of the series, Fusion is a close second. While they both play almost exactly the same, the story and enemies in the game make it different enough to stand out from its predecessor. Having Samus face the cloned ex-parasite of herself with all of her past most powerful abilities was a great twist to add to the edge-of-your-seat action. Samus X throughout the entire game is overpowered and hunting you. What I appreciated the most is you have the freedom to observe or attack, even though there is no possible chance of survival. It's funny to look how Super Metroid went from a cartridge that was the size of your hand to a cartridge the size of your pinky. I only wish this game could have been on a reproduction cart for the Super Nintendo that I could play. I give Metroid Fusion my must-own ranking. Be sure to hit the like button, and for more content like this, subscribe. If you'd like to be in contact with me, you can follow me on Twitter at RetroOrDie, and if you'd like to support the channel even more, you can find me on Patreon at RetroOrDie. And if you'd like additional content that you can't see here on YouTube, be sure to go to my website, www.RetroOrDiePodcast.com. This is where you'll get exclusive behind-the-scenes content, extra pictures, blog posts, as well as the full Retro or Die podcast episodes.